Very good morning, everyone, and welcome to today's market commentary. So Nifty took a very clear support from 10,550 to 10,580. The reason behind that is mainly because of this island reversal. So island reversal is a gap pattern. So below these candlesticks, you have a gap down, and after this candlestick pattern, you have a gap up. So these two candlesticks are isolated from the prior bearish rally and the after bullish rally. So these two are isolated. So that's the reason the name goes as island reversal. So island in the sense candlesticks getting isolated from the prior rally and an after rally. So and if you combine these two patterns also, this is a bullish engulfing candlestick pattern, which has a good amount of bullish sentiment. That means more number of buying has happened at that price zone, and that's the reason it did not give a chance to participants to enter into the rally. So the gap tells us the complete story here. So that gap up, it acted as a strong support for the first time here, second time, and yesterday for the third time. Not only that, if you see the expiry, weekly expiry of Nifty, the highest put option OI is built up at 10,600, which falls into this zone. So the low made yesterday was 10,585, which is very near to 10,600. So a lot of put option OI is built up there, which is also acting as a strong support. And if you enable the pivot points as well, the monthly S1 stands at the same zone, 10,613. So more or less all these factors are helping Nifty to take a support here. So if Nifty maintains its support and takes a good U-turn, not only that, so yesterday's candlestick pattern is also an inverted hammer, which happens at the end of a bearish rally, and from there a possible reversal can be seen in the market. So today the same reversal you can see, but it is not yet confirmed. If it makes a good green candle and closes above the closing price of this red candle, it becomes a morning star pattern. A gap down here yesterday, small gap down, and gap up today. And if it goes above and closes above the closing price of this candle, it becomes a morning star, and that is also a powerful bullish candlestick pattern. The two, this story is happening near the support zone. So all we need to do is to expect a, so like we need to have a morning star pattern here for a good reversal. Otherwise the strength is not enough for Nifty to go up. And revisiting the higher time frames, where is Nifty standing now? Did it break the trend line support or not is the major question. So it did not break the trend line support yet. It is still trading above that. So although Nifty looks bearish, but we need to concentrate mostly on the trend line support on the higher time frame. So which is not yet broken. So Feb month, we still have how many trading more days are left? 2, 3. And these are 4 days. So total 7 more trading days are left in Feb month. So we'll get a clear picture if candle closes below this or not. So always remember, if a candle closes below the trend line support, that candle itself will not act as a confirmation. So there should be another candle which should close below the low of this breaking candle. I'm repeating it again. So one candle closes below the trend line support, that does not give you the confirmation of bearishness. There should be another candle which closes below the low of this confirmation candle, that will give you the actual reversal or the actual starting of bearishness. So even if this candle closes below the trend line support, it does not indicate any starting of new bearish rally. There should be another candle which should close below the low of this candle. So first, this needs to close below support, and second, another candle needs to close below the low of this candle. Only then you'll get a confirmation of bearishness. So weekly time frame, we can just mark the support levels here, which we have already seen in earlier sessions as well. 9990 is your next level of support if Nifty trades below this trend line support here. On daily time frame, so on daily time frame, already the trendline support is broken, everything is done, but on monthly time frame it is still finding a support. And on daily, as we marked earlier, the support is intact here already. So when you compare monthly with daily, daily will have little volatility in its movement. And then coming to Bank Nifty, even Bank Nifty also, as you can see, the trend line support is broken. A candle closed below that, but there is no candle closing below the low of this confirmation candle. See, you have a classic example here. So this red candle closed below the trend line support, but next we'll need to have a candle which closes below the low of this candle, then the bearishness is confirmed. Until then, we cannot confirm the bearishness. And Bank Nifty on daily time frame, visibly 26,420 is the strongest support. So there you have a head and shoulders pattern as well. This is the left shoulder, head and the right shoulder. So strong bearishness can be seen only below 26,420, which is just 400 rupees away from the current trading price. Monthly, we have already seen this. It is trading way below the monthly support. So it is just facing resistance on the upside. That's it. And based on pivot points and all those things. So pivot points, it took a very clear support near S1 of this month. And then it bounced back. It did not even touch the support. So from around 50 rupees or so, it bounced earlier itself. Now the question is, will it sustain there? The prior trend line support, will it act as resistance or not? And then it might again face resistance and come down. So this is just a short covering that you need to see now. All these days you had a good bearish rally in both Nifty and Bank Nifty, and all of a sudden you can see that from the support levels there is a short covering happening. So still new bullish positions are not being added. That is the important point you need to note down. It is just a short covering. Means they are already short. Now in order to close their positions, they need to buy back. So that buying is causing this little bullish rally. But it is not new participants adding long positions, because you have an expiry tomorrow as well. So people want to be on safer side and they are closing their positions today itself. Now, since we can see short covering in index itself, so even the other stocks are also giving us the same. Price is approaching the support zone, and then from there it is showing us the short covering happening. So if at all BEML comes below 752, a good 26 point rally can be seen on the downside. And HDFC Bank also, it is bearish below 2078. So below 2078, long bearish rally can be seen until 2022. There is no support in between. And Hindustan Unilever, it is bearish below 1726. So below 1726, it can fall at least until 1662, because this zone you don't see any supports on the left. Even MFSL, Max Financial Services, there's a triangle pattern being formed here. So if this triangle gets broken on the downside, good bearish rally can be seen, and the final target what we can expect in the stock is 360. Then OFSS, Oracle Financial Services, even this stock is bearish below 3470. So below 3470, 3418 is what visible to us here. And finally, Repco Homes. So this is bearish below 310 and a short term target of 294. Just 2-3% on the downside can be expected in this stock. So India Bulls Housing Finance, as I told you earlier, it bounced back from the support zone, long term support zone. So this was the strongest support zone for India Bulls Housing Finance, and from there itself the stock bounced back. Now all we need to see is on daily time frame, is it going to sustain that or not? We cannot see any bullish divergence in both RSI or in the stochastic oscillator. We can at least take the help of put option. Even put option also is not in our favor because the highest put OI is at 700. So a little bit risky. I'm not sure if it is going to go up or not. RBL Bank standing right at the support zone, 542-534 is its support zone. Below that you can expect some bearish rally. Now gold bearish divergence is clearly visible here, price making higher high and RSA making a lower high. Now is it going to sustain is the question to us. Crossed the R1 already. Bearish patterns are not visible here, so we cannot take a chance, or else let's see the main chart itself on trading view. So first I'll look for what is the retracement value here. So for me it should be at least 0.618. It is not even 0.5. And then I'll look for, so if it was 0.618, I'll look for the extension. So it should at least be 1.618. So in near term, I cannot see any bearishness in gold. It might continue its bullish journey. Now, what you can do is just mark a horizontal line at the prior resistance zone. 1366 was the prior highest point of gold. So from there you can start searching for bearish opportunities again. Till then, do not think of any bearishness because it is not showing at all the bearishness. I think was that the lifetime high? No. So 1366 to 1375 is the area from where you need to start looking for bearish opportunities in gold. Now MCX is also providing you the open interest. So just go to mcxindia.com, market data, option chain, and from there you need to pick up the latest gold contract and see if there is any call OI built up. So gold, the nearest expiry is March 27, and go to the call option side and check for the highest option interest. So here the highest OI is built at 34,000 and currently it is trading at 33,935. But what we need to also see is at 34,000, do we have any other resistances being built up based on other indicators or based on the chart patterns, Fibonacci, etc.? We need to confirm even that. Then someone asked for Maruti. Dinesh, about which stock are you talking? Maruti, we saw that the trend line resistance is not letting the stock go up. So this was the trend line resistance that we saw in the stock. Other than that, no clear pattern is visible here. Yeah, Dinesh, what I told you is it should take support at 0.618 and it should face rejection at 1.618. But here if you see in the gold, it was taking support near 0.5. So that is not enough to us. And even Maruti also no clear direction. So these are the stocks, indices and commodities for today. Thank you all for joining.